Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, at Heinz Field. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up. Then he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line with the Kansas City Chiefs. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now Mahomes. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended target, and it's 3rd and 5.
Well, they decide to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Mark Barron drops him for a 4-yard loss there, and that brings up 4th down.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye. That happened fast and a big sack. On 4th down, on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away. Back deep for the Steelers, Ryan Switzer. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Big Ben and the Steelers with a 1st and 10 at their own 21. Play fake to Connor. Now Roethlisberger. Finds his running back, James Connor. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. This is a guy who made a Pro Bowl in his second season, James Conner. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. Chris Jones on the stop. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Black 20. Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball.
On second down, Connor looking for space. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
From the gun on 3rd down, it's Roethlisberger. But it's brought in by Washington. And he will have 1st down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. On 1st down, it's Roethlisberger, and that is incomplete. James Conner, the running back, his intended receiver, but it's going to be 2nd down.
So it looked like maybe his 3rd or his 4th read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41.
Come to my world. We want it. Come to my world.
Now it's Roethlisberger. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 15 yards on the play, 1st down.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
So first down went in the wrong direction. They're at the 13-yard line. Here's second and goal. Roethlisberger. That is caught inside the five. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A 10-yard completion, but still now facing third and goal.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
On third and goal, Roethlisberger got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown from 3 yards out, and the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the three and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on three and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told them how it was going to happen. They're going to run this. We're going to stop it. Then we're going to take the ball. They won't be able to keep up with us. And they got it done.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Let's go. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Here's a guy on his fourth franchise in 2 years, Carlos Hyde. Cameron Hayward in on the tackle.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
From the 30 on second down, Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Throwing now is Mahomes. On target over the middle to Hill. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A good pickup there, a 22.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Williams. He's got the first down here inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
Mike. Yellow. Here we go. What's that? 55. Right there in the middle. 55. Right there.
Mahomes now on first down. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they'll get this down to the 10. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Partner, they weren't quite in the red zone, but things are starting to get condensed on the field. Throwing the corner route there, really nice play because it gives them a little bit of room to complete it.
A first trip to the red zone for KC. They've got a first and 10 from the 10. Mahomes going to throw. This is caught. Watkins. A gain of 6 there on first.
Way to let them dogs loose.
Yellow. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Mahomes now to throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
The extra point up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately, because if you let that big guy get ahead of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Here's Roethlisberger. On the left side, it's McDonald. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 15 yards on the play, first down.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
There goes a deep ball, end zone, and that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down, Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time, and it's second down. Ah! Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the 2-minute warning. On second down now, it's Connor. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Again, it's Roethlisberger. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to...
And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. From 4 yards out, and the Steelers have taken the lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be taken in at the 1. It'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
They begin the drive with Williams. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On 2nd and 9, Mahomes looking left side for Watkins, and he's got it. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively, brings up 4th down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Colquitt on to kick as he sends it away. Switzer on the return. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Steelers will go on offense here, 1st and 10. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And complete to Moncrief over the middle. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Over to the right side, caught by Moncrief. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Completes it to Moncrief, left side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
Let's go!
Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers' field goal try. A 33-yarder from the left hash. And Boswell's kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. Boswell signed to a 4-year deal prior to last season, but he struggled a little bit.
Yeah, do you think that they saw 13 of 20 when they signed him to a 4-year deal?
Not at all.
Needs a big bounce back in 2019 if he wants to see the end of that contract.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'd love to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
And now this throw incomplete, and that is how this first half will come to an end. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
Fielded about a yard deep, and he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Nice play call, a little bit of play action right there. If you can get those linebackers to freeze for just a split second, that's usually all the room you need in order to get it to your tight end.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. On the counter, it's Connor. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And they're going to face a third down.
Here we go.
180.
Mike 50. Did you go get this, Norton? You think you go get this?
Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Set! Black five!
Watch the run!
Black is in!
They're running, man! Watch safety creep! Watch safety creeping! Safety
Black, what's that?
Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. This is caught at the 20. A big play. Smith-Schuster on the throw from Big Ben. And even 40 yards.
I know we love our jobs. And pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. And the ball is knocked out, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team. Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
From the 22, here's second and eight. They run it again with Williams. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast and in the open field, but, man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
Well, the stats that matter on this play don't help a team very much, unless, of course, you're playing defense.
If you're getting points per reception, you got a reception, but yeah, no yardage. Great job by the defense, though. They read through that one.
They read through it, gave up no yardage, and people got credit for tackles. Pretty good deal.
Again, that's Watkins.
Let's go, folks.
Mahomes to the former Rams, Sammy Watkins for the Kansas City first.
Has a pretty good throw on the curl route there. Third down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers to the quarterback, and complete the play.
Mahomes completes that one to Watkins. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Here's Mahomes to throw. Mahomes hit. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. He's at the 40. And he takes it back to the house. A fumble recovery for a Steelers score. The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that, and that's what they've done all game long.
Boswell good with the extra point, and that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This will be taken in at the one. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs on first and 10, right at the 30. They go play action. Now Mahomes. Under pressure, they got him again. Javon Hargrave, the D tackle, getting the sack. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Now Mahomes. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. The Chiefs on third down, just one for three thus far. This is going to be third and 13. To throw, it's Mahomes. And this is caught by Watkins. It's a gain of 26 as they pick up the first down of the process. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Caught, Kelce, left side. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask. 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10.
Here we go, here we go.
Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. That's going to be caught. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right.
And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Carlos Hyde taking it in, and the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
They go for just one here as it's up and good. And the lead down to 10, 24-14. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this doesn't work. The Steelers recover it. The risk-reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things. Now they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
Darren Lee there to get him down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time. And that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. Again, a run with Connor. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And the Steelers on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be third and 5. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And he finds McDonald. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 12 yards that time, but a Pittsburgh first. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish, because strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Second and 12, and you'd have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming. Roethlisberger will hand to Connor. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. The Steelers on third down. A perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is third and 9. On third down, it's Connor. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is. Here comes Mahomes and the Chiefs. Down 24-14. Just over a minute 40 to play. They'll need a score here and also likely an onside kick recovery. But first things first. First and 10. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. To throw is Mahomes. He's going to let it fly. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The Pro Bowler Tyreek Hill, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Looking to erase a two-score deficit here in the fourth quarter, going for some big plays.
Yeah, they certainly were. They just added one shot, didn't they? Forget trying to move the ball downfield in small little increments. Let's go for the big one. But how about the defense playing situational football, looking at the scoreboard, realizing what can hurt us most? The deep shot. They played it well.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. And that takes us from second to third down. play action, it's Mahomes. And unable to connect, incomplete. Well, give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Now here's Mahomes. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about Slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
They're down to none?
Yes, okay. Exactly right.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On first and 10 is Counter. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
It's easy work.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Roethlisberger dropping to a knee, and that ought to do it. So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first.
It's our time, guys. It's our time. Watch the ship. Watch the ship. Hey, watch the ship. Watch the ship.
So this one in the win column for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And it was due in large part once again to the play of big number 7, their quarterback, Ben Roethlisberger.
And as you and I both know, there can be some really good Big Ben days. There can be some not quite as good Big Ben days. But they're always going to be exciting, aren't they? He makes plays. He stands in the pocket and delivers against a fierce rush. He can exit out at times. There's something special about that guy, and no game is out of reach when he's on the field.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Steelers are winners as we say so long from Heinz Field.